why am I doing this? If I'm going to be honest, I got nothing else to do in my life. Really. I want to challenge myself, really. There's so many things I'm scared to do. I watched the show before and I'm like, what? That, my biggest worry is a Tucker trial. I gag when I smell things really awful. I mean, there's nothing that I'm not scared of. Heights, because I don't like what I see or not see below. That's the problem with heights. At least the creepy crawlies, I see them. How I'm preparing to go to the jungle is actually eating a lot more. So I can put on some weight and I can go from feast to famine. So I'm being smart about it. I'm not going to go in there ripped. I'm gonna go there with some real junk in my trunk, okay? Because I know what's coming. So I'm being clever about this. I'm the type of person who loves company. I can be by myself, but I prefer to have company. It's nice to banter with each other and, you know, share experiences. So I wouldn't say I'm a loner. I'm more of a people's person. I like company. But if no one wants to talk to me, I'm good too. I can go and sit down and I get the message very quickly. So the first impression I think people get of me is, oh my gosh, she's a lot nicer and more fun and easygoing than I thought. Yeah, Australia's made a magnified version of myself and once side. But there's a lot more to me that Australia hasn't seen, and that is the person I really am and where I come from and the simple things that I appreciate and do in life. My children, I live for them, and definitely dedication and hard work. You know, there's something about me, it's called verbal diarrhea. Sometimes things come out of my mouth so fast that I might regret when Julia and Chris puts me through hell. You know, I couldn't say I'm gonna fight with them because I won't mean to fight with them. In the camp environment, I would say I would be more of a team player. I would be there to support my teammates, to be there for them if they need something. But as a person in my own space and in my own life, I would say I'm more of a leader. My whole life has been life skills that I've learned. I mean, I have gone through every type of struggle to get me to where I am. I never stop learning. I'm still so far behind in knowing what I really want, because you think you know what you want and then you just get another challenge in front of you and you have to learn. I'm always learning. So that's my strongest attribute in life. Well, I came from a place that we had to create things from bits and bobs around the garden. So hopefully I'll have to go back to my childhood and sort of start to get my craft on. That's right. Well, when you're in the jungle, it doesn't mean you can't pamper yourself. If you can be creative, you can find things to do, like find some nice, good herbal leaves or medicinal leaves and berries and whatnot, and make a paste and put it all over your body. My hip exercise. Oh, yes. It looks awful, but it works amazing. You would think, you would look at me and go, what the hell is she doing? It's completely ludicrous looking. So I'm going to teach people that if they want to learn it. It's going to be hard not being able to talk to my kids. I mean, right now, I just want to call them every day and talk to them. And let me tell you, if not for my boys saying, Mom, you don't have a life. Go get a life. Go and do this. I would have not been here. I'm not even kidding you. They were like, you have to go. God, no one will miss me. They're all probably thinking, damn, great. We get some peace for a moment. My charity is Beyond Blue. The charity is amazing with anxiety and depression, especially this year with COVID. It makes me so sad. And Beyond Blue does an amazing job. And at this time, right now, I think that charity needs all the help it can get, because there is so many people in need. They're working around the clock and we need to support this charity. The first thing I would want to do when I leave the jungle is go and hug my boys. Secondly, I've knocked back a few Negronis. What does success on this show mean to me? Everything. Because firstly, I would like to show Australia who I am. I have a great opportunity on this show to do that. And I want Australia to fall in love with me, to fall in love with the person I really am. That's who I want Australia to fall in love with.